Welcome back to Let's Play the Outer Worlds. Blind, I am Amethyst Lunatari, now heading towards Byzantium. Believe it or not. Where is it? We're on Monarch. Oh, duh, right here. But that's Terra 2. So Byzantium is also on Terra 2. Oh, okay. I had no idea. For some reason, I thought it was completely different.
We are now in orbit above Byzantium, Captain.
Planet, moon, something. Yeah, that threw me. Who should I bring? Oh, wait, who's... Minister Clark. Kill Dr. Chardran. Ellie wants you to take her to visit her parents in Byzantium when you're in the area. Okay. So I think... And we want to steal something too, so we need sneaky person and Ellie. Felix, for all I know, I haven't, like, played for a week or so. I don't remember what I said at the end of the last episode, but, well, he has good sneak, Felix. Max has good hack and science. Hack and science, intimidate. Oops. Naoka's good at sneak, too. But Felix is also good at lockpick. I think Ellie and Felix then. Bijou review. Yes, flagging inventory as junk. I don't bother with that, I just go through it manually. Oh my. Oof. Restarting a second. And this is our thing. So we can call the ship here if we want to. That's Phineas's contact. Let me just take a look around here a little bit. Hello, construction mechanical. Very sunny right here. Shh. Don't you shush me. Ooh, we got here like a toss ball thingy. You missed out, Felix. Yeah, I think that thing would see me. Ooh. Wouldn't be seen here, though.
Real slick.
I try. Nope, not doing anything suspicious over here. Absolutely not. What else might we have?
Are you still tinkering with that?
It's not gonna fix itself.
Don't we have repair drones for that kind of thing?
This was a repair drone.
Hmm. What repairs the repair drones?
Hey.
Hey, hey.
I don't have time for this.
I'm just standing around.
So what if those MSI suits have been on Marnark this whole time? I can do it. Easy.
You say so. Any other goodies before I talk with this contact here? Nothing we could grab without possibly getting caught. Didn't mean to do that. I meant to land safely. This one we can pick up freely. Not sure why. Oh. Okay. Ellie's standing right next to the contact. Hello. Carmen Imagawa.
Do you mind? I'm meeting someone.
Yeah, Phineas sent me.
Shh. No names, okay? The Phoenix is a wanted man and the board has eyes everywhere in Byzantium.
The Phoenix?
Yeah. That's my code name for... you know, our mutual friend.
Huh. Okay, what's your code name?
Oh. I'm Golden Eagle.
Do I have a code name?
Yeah. I named you Cuckoo.
No way. I'm Golden Eagle. You can be Cuckoo.
That doesn't even make... fine. Fine.
Does this mean I'm supposed to have one too? Fine. But make it a really good one.
Let's go with Rufus Hummingbird.
Forget it. Codenames are for amateurs anyway.
Too late. I've already marked it off. Can't just go reassigning codenames.
Well, we just did.
Can we pick our own codenames? I want to be rolling thunder. Wait, no, I got it. Dropkick millstone. Yeah.
I was really trying to stick with the bird theme. How about bullfinch?
Wow, that is so much better. Bullfinch millstone.
Okay, but adding your last name kind of misses the point.
Yeah.
Anyway, you're looking to make contact with Minister... Magpie, right? I should warn you, it won't be easy. He spends most of his time in his estate, which is heavily guarded.
Okay, it... The code name for estate, though, is Birdcage. You messed that up. There's gotta be a way to catch the minister someplace less protected.
Afraid not. He almost never leaves his home, and his guards never leave him.
Hmm. How exactly did you get involved in this, anyway?
I've always been fascinated by birds. If you ever research Earth species, there are thousands of them. So colorful and distinct. The other thing about birds, though, is their environmental indicators.
I didn't think this had anything to do with birds. Environmental indicators, like the canary in a coal mine, right? When they die off, it's a sign that something's wrong.
Exactly. I started thinking about everything we see around Halcyon, and all the things we don't see.
Like what?
For starters, you rarely come across anyone living in Byzantium who wasn't born here, even though we get ships in all the time.
Trust me, anyone with a lick of sense gets out of here as soon as possible.
But most people don't. In fact, most people stay exactly where they start. Doesn't that seem strange to you?
It does, actually.
And then there's the way nothing gets fixed. There used to be a suggestion box around here. People would drop ideas in. Nothing ever came of them, of course.
Of course.
Sounds like my old job. I had all these bang-up ideas, you know? Like making everybody haul their own damn boxes. Never did catch on, though.
That's what I mean. Everyone needs a suggestion box so they can voice their thoughts. So what if nothing changes?
Yeah, it's not right.
I mean, there's a shredder at the bottom of the box, so I don't know what you'd expect to happen.
Oh, there is?
But one day the shredder broke. No one came to fix it. And since it wasn't working, we didn't have anywhere to file our complaints. So you can imagine how messy things got.
And?
At first, management put up an out-of-order sign, but that just seemed to worry people, like they were advertising something wasn't working. They eventually took the whole suggestion box sign down so that people didn't have any expectations about it. But they never fixed it, never replaced it. Doesn't that seem odd to you?
Well, if you ask me, the suggestion box is pretty useless to begin with.
I don't know how else people are supposed to complain about things they can't change. But that's not the point. The whole episode made me wonder. If they can't fix something as simple as a suggestion box, what else aren't they fixing? After a while, I got connected with our mutual friend and started using my position here to feed him information when I could. That's it, really.
Hmm. Well, can't you get me into the minister's estate?
Whoa, I'm not one of your B&E specialists. I just provide intelligence.
It's debatable. So what can you tell me?
Some of the guards hang around Billingsley's House of Inebriation between shifts.
That place is still open? I used to study there during medical school.
Maybe you could do some reconnaissance there. You know, swipe a key while nobody's looking.
Okay. Inebriation House, or whatever she said. Okay. Thanks for the tip.
Just remember, you didn't hear it from me.
Alright, well, looks like I got some work to do.
Good hunting, Golden Eagle.
Thanks, Cuckoo. Sweet.
What is it? I'm trying to keep a low profile. Good hunting, Golden Eagle.
Cuckoo! Hello? So we've got stuff. Yeah, I think that's where I'm gonna put it. They don't get anything this time. Minister Clark, Minister's Guard. Oh, that's a door there. Okay. Alright, so we met the contact. Some Minister's Clark's guards hang out at a local bar. One of them might be able to provide some information regarding Clark's residence. Mr. Clark spends almost all of his time at his estate, which is under heavy guard. He may be hard to reach, but he's apparently been hoarding the colony's reserves of dimethyl sulfoxide. So we're going to speak to the guards first. Just out of curiosity. Chartrand is that way. Not that means much to me at this point. Ellie's parents. Also that way. I thought this thing was glowing. I can't open that.
That's what we really need, you know.
More of you standing in my light?
A repair drone that repairs itself. Like, an auto repair drone.
Warehouse? Alright, I give up. How do I get out of this place? Wait. Aha! Hole in wall. Elevator. Alright. Tyrese.
I wonder if I'll get to meet Chairman Rockwell.
All my hard work's finally paid off.
You guys just hang out here?
Once I'm retired, I'm gonna drink all the zero-G I can handle.
Once I'm retired, I'm gonna drink all the zero-G I can handle.
Okay.
Nothing exciting ever happens around here.
I wonder if I'll get to meet Chairman Rockwell.
I wonder if I'll get to meet Chairman Rock...
Can you believe I'm retiring? Lucky me.
Feels like I've been waiting in line forever.
So you guys are waiting in line to retire?
The law is really looking out for me. Once I'm retired, I'm gonna drink...
It feels like I've been waiting in line forever.
The law's really looking out for me.
Sealed.
Security attendant
is always prepared. Move along. Nothing exciting ever happens around here. Requires docking bay, terminal codes to unlock. Is that the only computer? Back here are goodies.
I can take a hint.
Hi.
Move along.
Toss ball. You got an actual. All these toss ball sticks we find, and now we got an actual toss ball. I need that. I need the toss ball. With his back turn, maybe? Cool.
Nice going.
Cool. Okay. All right, so now what do I do? Is this the way we... No. Well, I guess the only place to go is up here. Wherever this takes us. Come on, guys, get down. This is a very long elevator ride. I imagine we must be up very high. Look at that. We could take the quick way down.
Why can't something exciting happen around here for once?
Nothing wrong with stability. It means everything's running like clockwork.
Nice hat.
Don't you ever want a little fun? Maybe see a marauder ship get blown to bits overhead?
What a thing to say. Everyone knows marauders can't fly.
I don't think I've ever seen a marauder ship. A mailbox. Parcel delivery. Look at that. Parcel service. HPS Halcyon. We've got robot janitors.
Down there, a new ship. Doesn't look like any of the corporate freighters.
But what would they be doing here? And how did they ever get permission to land?
I make my own permission.
Perhaps we'll finally get some excitement after all.
I tried to give you some excitement, but all you did was say, Quarantine. Sprat sighted. Not quarantined. That's a hydrant, but it's glowing. You stand on this and this opens? No, okay.
Hey, you. Yeah, you. Wanna be famous?
Who, me?
Kid, you got presence. Natural magnetism. Know what I mean?
Maybe I like where this is going.
Tell you what, you're gonna like it a whole lot more once we start talking bits.
I like bits.
Listen, you got an agent? Some kind of representation?
Does working for a mad scientist count?
A mad scientist? Guy sounds like he's moonlighting. Here's some free advice. If you want to make it in this business, you got to work with professionals. Listen, you got a real special quality, raw energy. I see you in pictures, kid.
Alright, just tell me what you're offering.
I'm making a feature, Space Pirates of Moros Prime. It's gonna be a hit. But we still need a star, and I think you got the chops.
Boss, we have to.
We?
Your pal's got the right idea. He's also got a certain expendable look. Bring him along. We've got a lot of stunts to shoot.
Oh boy.
What do you say? You ready for the chance of a lifetime?
Well, sounds interesting. I have a feeling I'm going to regret it, but I'm in.
Terrific. We're holding auditions at the studio. Head to Odeon Pictures and take the elevator. You're going all the way to the top, baby.
I just took an elevator to the top. Yeah, hold on.
You're going to be big. I can feel it.
Feel it. Did you see that? Okay. Maverick Johnston, a Byzantium film producer, thinks you've got the makings of a star. He invited you to audition for the lead role in his film, Maverick said the audition would be held on the top floor of the Odeon Pictures building, wherever the hell that is.
Anti-Creo's facial mask and cream leaves you feeling fresh and tingling. Do not operate heavy machinery for 2 hours after application.
Keep in mind, salon club closed. So I'm not getting through there.
Our UDL security attendant is always prepared.
Good to know.
So what if all those MSI suits made it on Monarch this whole time? I could do it. Easy.
This place is pretty awesome looking.
Enjoy 6 cups worth of concentrated caffeine.
Closed for R&R, repairs and renovations. Whoa.
According to local legend, if you walk around the orrery 3 times, your corporate rival will die of a paper cut.
Just imagine busting up all these windows, looting all these stores.
Prosperity Plaza.
The dissidents actually took over the refinery. I can't believe it!
Forsyth Luxury Munitions.
And then, the chairman shot their space shuttle down with a Hammersmith grenade launcher. Incredible.
Are you two talking about the new Dissident Hunter adaptation? Don't spoil it. I'm behind.
You need to watch more Aetherwave. You never know what's going on.
Move along.
Don't tell me what to do.
Huh?
Have time for this.
Why the hell not? Pardon the mess, we're getting a facelift. Love Grove's beautification. Cosmetic serums, toiletry, salves. Griffic Jewelers is closed. Alright, so let's check out this munitions place.
Ago was supposedly based on a real incident.
That is cool looking.
You mean the one where the dissidents blew up an orphanage? That's awful.
Thank the law we live in Byzantium, right?
It's made up.
I only wish they weren't showing so many
guns, weapons, ammunition
ads in the commercial breaks. Who do they think their audience is?
You can't blame them for wanting to appeal to the masses, I suppose.
I think it lends the whole program a rather quaint touch.
That's interesting door sound. Hello. Winston Forsyth?
Looking for weapons? You've come to the right place. Every Byzantine needs high-quality armament, and you won't find better anywhere else.
Nice eye patch. What do people around here need weapons for, anyway?
Why, to defend their property, of course.
50-bit says he's got a hard-on right now.
Byzantium is the best of what Halcyon has to offer. It's up to us to protect it.
You ought to worry about protecting your eyes. What happened? Are you running with scissors?
Oh.
What? Oh, the eye patch is just for show.
What?
But the weapons are all real and of the highest quality.
What do you need to protect Byzantium from?
Marauders, dissidents, especially large sprats. One never knows what threat might arise.
Byzantium seems pretty safe to me.
Only because we make it so. It is only the fear of the well-armed Byzantine that keeps the rabble at bay.
Whatever you say.
Indeed. Now, what are you in the market for, my fine friend?